Match Game, Hollywood Square. Our Live from Another World, Richard J. Porter. Deidre Bowles. Hollywood Square Tower, G. Raymer and John Bowman.
Are y'all ready? Listen, before the week is up, I gotta ask you one thing.
Wait, you guys at
WKRP Cincinnati looked as if you were having a wonderful time. I hope you were all friends and did have a wonderful time. And if you didn't, don't tell them, don't disillusion me.
Okay.
No, we did. We had a marvelous time.
Yeah.
It was like a family.
Yeah, well, you were really terrific in that series.
Lonnie is about the best daughter you could ever have, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Enough said.
Just checking up on everybody up here. What do you say, buddy? How are you?
I hate to complain.
Well, I'm sorry I asked. What's your problem?
I know that everyone here has been trying to do the best they can for me.
Yeah.
They send limos for the other guests. They give me the privilege of driving myself to the studio. The other guests have fruit baskets in their room.
Yeah.
I have a box of prunes.
What?
I'm not complaining, but I don't seem to have a rapport with the audience.
Now, wait a minute. Everybody loves you, Robert.
It isn't working, Gene. And at great expense to me, I have brought my director of communications to try and bridge this gap between myself and the audience. I introduce Crazy George.
Is it all right if I go on with the show now? Well, I guess it's going to work to bring your own clack here, a cheerleading session. That makes two of you in the room now who have gone bananas. Okay.
George is a professional man.
Yes, he sure is. And he's got a great pair of tonsils, I can tell you that. Well, I hope that things are going to be better for you from now on, Robert. We aim to please around here. We don't want you to feel bad.
God bless you, Gene.
We want you to feel good.
God bless you, Gene.
Thank you. Would you join me in a little applause for our two civilian contestants here, Nancy Shirley and Terry Henry? Hey, Nancy.
Hi.
Where are you from and all that?
I'm from Bakersfield, California. I'm a secretary. I have my own business, and I work mainly out of my home, primarily, so I can be home. I have two sons, ages 5, now 6, and 8, and I'm married to a fireman. We've been married for 13 years, and we support our children in school activities and local community activities.
Good for you. And you have very pretty teeth. You must take care of them,
thank
right?
Thank you. I try.
Good. All right. Terry, tell us about you, please.
Well, I'm from Long Beach, California, and I just recently started my own business. And we manufacture and design parts and accessories for the sport of board sailing.
Board sailing?
Yes.
Windsurfing, we call it.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah.
Can you do that?
Yes.
I can do it, but it ain't easy, I'll tell you that. Well, first day you're up there, you fall 47 times, and from climbing back on the board is rough, you know, so your feet don't slip. And every time you climb up, is little like a little sandpaper here. And at the end of the day, it's all rough and red and swollen, and it's awful. Yeah, I guess I'm going to quit that sport there. All right. The winner here of the match game will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Nancy Shirley, you won the toss, and that means you will go first. I will push my magic button here. Oh, there it is. You may have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
All righty. Here we go. Only took four pushes of the magic button, but sometimes magic buttons don't work. Hey, my wife is such a bad cook. Oh, forget it. You're out of it. You are off the payroll, friends. My wife's such a bad cook, we sell her soup as blank remover. Here we go dancing. My wife is such a bad cook, we sell her soup as blank remover.
Paint remover.
Paint remover is good, Nancy. Number good choices here. That was one of them. What do you say, Gordon?
Well, I was in the right area, but not the right surface.
Right. Wallpaper, wallpaper remover. Anything good here?
Sit down, George.
Audience, that's why Robert brought in his own claque, because you're unfair with your booing. Now, that's not a bad answer. Anything like paint remover. You are incorrigible. Okay, Robert.
I said nail polish remover. Love is where you find it. Don't be blinded.
Okay.
I like that Crazy George.
Yeah,
I want to miss
George.
My publicist.
He's up there.
You said paint remover.
She said paint remover.
Well, I said paint remover.
Good. Hold it. Are you going scuba diving during the course of the show?
I'm taking off on the next flight. Actually, I was talking to Robert, and I wondered why he got to come on the show without a tie. And they said, well, you know, it's golf. He's got that image. So I said, well, I'm from Houston. At least I can play up the space thing. Kind of.
That's it. That's
up
a space jacket. Very unusual and very handsome, too, I think. Hey, John, we sell her soup as blank remover.
Well, first of all, I think we should give Robert the limousine and the fruit basket.
I agree with you.
That would be my vote.
To keep Crazy George out of the studio.
What do you say?
Right.
Okay. Second of all, I think we should find some contestants with last names, because Nancy Shirley and Terry Henry strikes me as kind of peculiar. Other than that, the reason I'm saying all this right now is because I'll probably never play again because I said paint.
Okay, Fanny.
I'd like to contact that crazy person in the audience later. I said hair remover.
Hair remover. You want to employ him, in, put him in your
Could
service?
Could I use you for just a second? Hair.
See,
he doesn't have any.
George is loyal, if
he
nothing
can't
else.
Relate.
George
can't
is loyal relate. To Robert Donner, and that's the end of that there. Nidra.
Paint remover.
Okay.
All right.
All right, Terry, let's see what we got for you. Hey, Maxine said, my husband is so boring, he's put more people to sleep than blank. Got it? A lot of good choices in this round. That's good. Okay, Terry. Maxine said, my husband is so boring, he's put more people to sleep than blank.
Johnny Carson?
Johnny Carson is good. You don't understand. You don't understand. Here's the logic. Johnny Carson is on late at night.
Yeah.
And people go to sleep sometimes during the show because it's a late show, or sometimes right after the show. That's what she meant by that, and it's not a booable answer.
Well, you got us out of that one.
Well, figuring that most people use pills to go to sleep, and he's got to be better than that, I said put more people to sleep than pills.
Sleeping pills, okay? Robert, have you thought of getting your own show? You wouldn't have to have a studio audience. You'd have one guy out there banging his drum.
I have my own show, Gene.
Yeah, I know it. I can see that.
I said a hypnotist.
Aha! Look into my eyes. Okay.
George, you're losing him.
I think George is losing control there. Richard?
Terry, I was with you, except a different channel.
The Late Show. You know, if you'd said The Tonight Show, they might have matched that, although it's hard to tell. Okay, John, put more people to sleep then.
You can relate to this one, Crazy George, because this guy looks like you, except he pretends that he has hair. Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell is a good response.
Come on, George. Come on, give me a job. That's my boy.
Okay, Fanny.
How much is he paying you? I'll double it. Triple it. Sleeping pills.
Well, he's wealthy in his own right. Nidra.
Well, first I said hot milk, and then I realized that is not a person, see.
Right.
So then I said Oral Roberts, but I'll probably hear from him, too.
He doesn't watch this.
Very good, Nidra. Now, at the end of round one, Nancy Shirley is ahead 3-0. Round two will be along in a moment or so. So hurry back right after these messages.
Fun.
Tub.
Call 1-800-882-2858 for our free exclusive new shower package.
Here we go with round two. Nancy, you're ahead. You have to go first.
Try A this time. A.
A it is. Here we go. Kevin went to sleep, and he dreamed. He dreamed he was an Olympic shot putter. When he woke up, he discovered he had tossed his blank out the window. All right. Here we go, Gordon. Ready? In the slot. Nancy. Kevin went to sleep and dreamed he was an Olympic shot putter. When he woke up, he discovered he had tossed his blank out the window.
Assuming he was married, his wife.
Aha! Uh-huh. His wife. I don't know whether he was married or not. He said his wife, Gordon. What do you say?
Well, that's a heck of an answer.
Heck of an answer?
Yeah. Well, wish I thought of it. Shoes.
Tossed his shoes. Listen, you know who you have to get for your next appearance on the show. Yeah, all right. Is it a
wife
winner?
Wife is a wonderful answer.
Wife is wonderful. Oh. Wife is wonderful. Okay. Can you hear me? Your eardrum's broken?
Wife.
Wife it is. Now, Terry, you got a little catching up to do.
That's right.
Pay attention now. Winky Dink. what?
Crazy George. Oh,
I thought. This guy's name is Wink Dinky. Wink Dinky, the world's peppiest game show host, said, "Ever wonder why I sound so peppy? It's easy. Before every show, I drop some blanks down my pants." Wink Dinky is speaking. Here we go, Terry. Wink Dinky, the world's peppiest game show host, said, "Ever wonder why I sound so peppy? It's easy. Before every show, I drop some blanks down my pants."
Some mice down my pants?
Mice. Mice, eh? Mice might do it. I don't know. Let's see if we get any mice over here. George? Gordon?
Gordon, little red ones.
Little red ones. Ants in his pants.
He thought about it.
Uh-oh.
Robert! Robert!
Take it away, Robert. It's my show, dummy!
Now, Gene, I want you to use your imagination.
Yes.
And your intelligence. Mice cubes.
Ah.
You don't buy it, huh?
Wait, hold everything. We didn't get a buzz or a bell yet. They're thinking about it because the word mice is there. And they've got to come to a decision. They're conferring now.
They don't need to confer too far.
Though I can hear their voices.
I've altered my ballot.
You've altered your ballot?
Yes, I altered my ballot.
Now, wait a minute.
They
did not give it to you, Robert.
It's not your fault, Gene.
No. They did have a lengthy conference.
Winky Dink, right? That was his name.
No, Wink Dinky.
Wink Dinky. Oh, yeah. God. Well, I felt left field on this, so I just went with... Wink Dinky with Pop Rocks.
I dropped some Pop Rocks down my pants. I don't know what that means, and I'm not going to ask. Okay, John, I dropped some blanks down my pants.
Sure, that screwed me up, because this only applied to Wink Dink, Winky Dink. It didn't really apply to Wink Dinky, you see. Jumping beans.
Jumping beans. Fanny, what came to your mind?
Wink Dinky came
Wink
to my mind.
Wink Dinky, yes.
I think I've been out with Wink Dinky. I said hot peppers.
Hot peppers. Oh, that'll make it jump around a lot. It really will. Now, here comes the moment of truth. Nedra, what it was?
Mexican jumping beans.
Mexican jumping beans. That's true, though. There we are at the end of round two, 5-0 in Nancy's favor. Round three, the final round, right after this.
Come on. 229516 or go online to trytagaway.com. Don't delay, order now.
Here we go with round three, the final round. Nancy.
I'll try B this time.
All right, one person plays. Gordon Jump.
Uh-oh.
You alone. You alone. But you may get some help. The circus owner said, "I think the great Zambezi is losing his nerve. He won't even walk across the street without a blank." Okay, Nancy. "I think the great Zambini is losing his nerve. He won't even walk across the street without a blank."
A balance bar?
A pole, yeah.
Pole.
Balance bar, okay.
Pole.
That's it. That was one of the two good responses here, Gordon.
Yeah, that was a responsible response.
Yes.
But even more responsible response is net.
And that's what you had. That was the other good one. Net and balance pole are the two good ones. Terry, that gives you a shot at winning. But you've got to match all six to win,
right.
Five to tie, however.
Right.
Listen carefully now. Farmer Brown said, "After that last earthquake here in California, the weirdest thing happened. I milked my cows, and instead of milk, I got blank." All right. I think we're about ready, aren't we? Yeah. Okay, Terry. Farmer Brown said, "After that last earthquake here in California, the weirdest thing happened. I milked my cows, and instead of milk, I got blank."
Milkshakes.
Milkshakes. Like that, huh? Everybody loves milkshakes.
Yeah, but only if you got cold hands would you get a milkshake.
Oh, yeah, right.
Cottage cheese.
Cottage cheese. Terry, you got to match all the rest of them to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Robert.
Cream.
Cream, so that means Nancy Shirley wins the game. Come on down, Nancy. Okay. Right here. We'll get you in a moment. Terry, it was a pleasure to meet you. We're going to send some gifts to you from the match game. Terry Henry, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes. Now, we congratulate you. Now it's time to switch to Hollywood Squares. Here comes the rest of the set, so we can have 9 stars out here. 3 stars will make their appearance in a moment or so. We've got John and I will change places up here. We've got lots more excitement, so don't go away. We'll be right back.
member of our studio audience will receive Tappan's Deluxe Microwave Oven with Tappan Touch Controls, built-in browner, 10 different cooking speeds, so you can program to defrost and cook automatically, furnished by Tappan. It's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Square, our with from Hotel Nathan Cook. From Dallas, Ken Krenzema. Miss America 1983, Deborah Sue Matson. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Okay, we're here at National Robert Diner. Crazy George Hour continues.
When the kids turn unholy.
And now, John Baldwin at the Hollywood Square.
See, George likes you. Yes, you're a popular favorite. Okay, welcome to the second half of the Match Game, Hollywood Square's Hour. This is Nancy Shirley. She made her way through the Match Game. We also have three new celebrities. They are Ken Kercheval from Dallas, Deborah Sue Maffitt, Nathan Cook. And only one of them was Miss America of 1983. Yes, Nathan stood up. What? Something happened recently in your personal life, Nathan Cook.
In my personal
from
life.
Hotel.
Yes.
Yeah, tell us.
As of January 4th, I'm no longer available, ladies. I'm married. Yeah.
Well, I guess the operative question is, how married are you, Nathan?
I'm very, very.
Yeah, you're enjoying it so far? So far, so good?
So far, so good. Except Crazy George, now I don't know. Miami, let's see, Vikings, Bud Grant, Oakland A's, Billy Martin. Don't bang your drum for me, George.
Okay, so far, so good for Nathan's marriage. So far, so good for you, Nancy. One more time, let's play Hollywood Squares, your next game. It is one more time for you. You have been here once, Diego Domingo. You amassed in that day $5,625. Not
bad. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And I see you haven't lost your enthusiasm.
Not at all.
No.
No, sir.
Have you always been this enthusiastic, Diego, or only is it only when you win money?
It helps to win money, yes. Yes.
I suppose you'd like to win some more. We're going to play
Definitely.
Hollywood Squares one more time, and we're going to play it until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. You won $5,000 yesterday. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square that is captured. You get to start, champ. Take a look at him, pick a star, and let's go.
Robert, please.
Yeah, you gotta train this guy better on his cues there, Bob. Okay.
Didn't mean it, Robert.
Are you beginning to regret this? Robert, who is more apt to get a wart? Helen Hayes or a member of the singing group Menudo?
Well, this may surprise you, but warts are not caused by frogs or age. It's chilling. Chilling.
So who eats more chili, Helen Hayes or the singing group Menudo?
Menudo.
Okay. Well, listen, this guy brought his own drummer, so he must know something about groups. He says a Menudo is more apt to get a wart than Helen Hayes. What do you say?
I disagree.
A member of the singing group Menudo is more apt to get a wart. You should have agreed with Robert. Your opponent gets the first square. Robert, unfortunately for us, happened to be right. The reason his reasoning couldn't have been more crazy. Adolescents are more susceptible to warts. That is the reason.
Yeah.
Nancy? Nancy Shirley, you're playing O. Pick a star.
Nathan, please.
Need you to say
Nancy.
Nathan Cook,
yes.
When is your body hotter? Earlier in the early in the morning or late at night? Or right this minute?
As a newlywed. No. Let's see. I'll go for the obvious, and I will say late at night because you've been moving all day and got body heat, and now get me out of this.
Agree or disagree? He says late at night.
I agree with him.
Late at night it is. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square and you're off to a very, very good start. You got two O's up there. And Diego Domingo, you are playing X.
Gene DeBlock.
Yeah.
Gene DeBlock.
Yes, please.
You missed this one. The first game belongs to Nancy Shirley. Gene Rayburn, which is more, the price of a new Rolls-Royce Corniche or the combined price of everything in the Sears Christmas catalog?
Now, the regular catalog is about so thick.
Right.
Christmas catalog is is about so thick. A Corniche is over $100,000. I would venture that you could buy everything in that Sears Christmas catalog for less than $100,000.
So the Corniche costs more.
Right.
Agree or disagree to block, Diego?
Agree with me, dummy.
I'll agree, sir.
Should have disagreed because the Sears catalog, everything in the Sears catalog costs more. Your opponent gets a square and wins the first game in a clean sweep, 3-0 in a row. Here are the figures. In the Sears catalog, everything in the Sears Christmas catalog costs just over $250,000. A Rolls-Royce Corniche only costs $157,000.
Well, that was right.
But can you order it by mail? Okay. Think about that while we break. We'll be back with a $200 game after these messages.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares Hour.
In the 21st century, a shot.
Children need your support now more than ever. Please call now.
Now back to John Baumann and the Hollywood Square.
Well, okay, welcome back, everybody. It's 175 to zip. Nada, nada, Diego Domingo. But it's early yet.
Right.
You get to start this game. It's worth $200. Pick a star.
Robert, please.
Audience, you know the old phrase, hit him again, harder, harder. Any of you willing to try that? Be my guest. Okay, Robert Donner, when the no smoking sign goes on in a U.S. passenger plane, is the pilot supposed to put his cigarette out too? Or can he keep on smoking because he's the pilot?
When the no smoking sign goes on?
Right. Do you understand this question, George? Because
I would say that a pilot is allowed to do whatever he wishes in the privacy of his own cockpit, but I would say he would have to extinguish his smoke also in case, you know, somebody was looking.
He says the pilot has to put his cigarette out as well, Diego. Agree or disagree?
I'll agree with Robert.
Yes, you are on the board. The pilot has to put out his cigarette, too. And you first square, and you're on the board, and it's 4-0 for Robert Donner. Okay, Nancy, your move. You're playing O.
I'll go with Ken, please.
Pardon me?
Ken.
Okay, Ken Kercheval from Dallas. Do elephants dream, Ken? Or is that something only human beings do?
Let's see. Elephants. Well, dogs dream. Because they go like that. I'll bet they do. They have, you know, if they've got those memories, I'll bet they do. I'll bet they dream big.
It's not if they remember their dreams, Ken. It's just if they dream.
All right.
Okay. He says elephants dream. What do you say, Nancy?
I think they do. I agree.
Elephants do dream, yes. And they probably do remember them. Okay, you get the square. We got an O and an X up there. It's even up, Diego. Pick a star.
Yes, I'll try, Richard, please.
Okay. It's even up in this game. However, you are behind overall. Richard J. Porter. Richard J. from Another World. You're dining out. As dessert, you're having some cherries. Now, according to etiquette for every day, how should you get rid of the pits? Should you? Stick your fingers in your mouth and take them out.
Mm-hmm.
or should you use a spoon?
Well, I know that when I have my cherries with its withered... Oh, come on. All right, I think I better just let this one go across. Definitely, definitely, I always put it in the spoon and set it down on the saucer.
So you should use a spoon. Agree or disagree, Diego?
I disagree.
Smarty pants. You should take them out with your fingers, according to etiquette for every day. Okay. Very well done, Diego. You're perfectly right. You do get the square.
Thank you.
Yes. Gag the audience with a spoon. Okay, Nancy Shirley, you're playing O. Make your move.
Gordon to block.
You missed this one. Diego takes the game and gets the lead. Gordon, jump.
Yes.
When do hens lay more eggs? When they're nice and warm or when they're a little chilly?
Well, actually, when they're nice and warm.
Agree or disagree to block?
I'll agree.
When they're warm is correct. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square. You do block, and we are in the middle of a very exciting fracas here. We're going to be back to finish it after these messages. Come back to it.
In the 21st century, a shopper will...
Shop our stock-up sale, plus get free shipping when you shop omahasteaks.com/TV.
225, 250, or rather, you have 50, yes. You're a little bit behind, but there is still a bit of time. You are playing X.
Gene to block, please.
You missed this one to game, and a bigger lead belongs to Nancy.
A dramatic moment.
Come on, Gene. Gene.
Yes.
You're a duck.
Sure I am. Quack, 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 quack.
As long as we're in agreement. Quack. What do you have more of in your meat? Fat or protein?
Quack, 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 quack. The layer of adipose tissue on a duck is about 3/4 of an inch. And the muscle tissue is far thicker than that.
Oh.
So I would say definitely protein. Was that the question?
I don't know, but you gave me an answer.
That's it.
More protein.
Right.
More protein in duck meat, he says. Agree or disagree to block, Diego?
I agree.
There is more fat in duck meat. You should have disagreed with Gene. Once again, Diego. So convincing. Okay. 3-0s in a row, 2 games in a row. A lead of 450-50, but there is still time. Clear the board. Sweep off all the X's. Get rid of all the O's. Start another game. This one's worth $300. Diego Domingo,
Robert,
your move.
Please.
Oh, Robert! These guys. Here we go. Back here. Time's running out on the contestants.
Yes,
Robert,
Robert,
you can do this without Crazy George. Your dog sees you naked, and you think he's grinning at you. According to the book, Understanding Your Dog, can your pooch grin, or are you paranoid?
You want a quick answer to this?
Yep.
I'm paranoid.
Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Yes, you're right to disagree. Your dog can grin. Anyone's dog can grin. Robert may still be paranoid, but your dog can grin. Okay. He was wrong. He had no idea. Okay, Nancy Shirley, your move.
Nathan, please.
It's nice. George even cheers for you when you're wrong. Okay, Nathan Cook, what lasts longer? What lasts longer?
Uh-huh.
No, this is good for you. The average honeymoon?
Mm-hmm.
Or a can of store-bought whipped cream?
Can of store-bought whipped cream on honeymoon?
I mean, how, you know, the whipped cream. Nathan, as far as the whipped cream, it's how long it keeps.
Oh.
You know, how long it will keep rather than how long it takes to use it.
Oh, that's a whole different light. I will definitely say the whipped cream than the average honeymoon. Not my honeymoon, honey. No. The average.
Agree or disagree that the whipped cream will keep longer than the honeymoon?
I agree.
Yes, whipped cream it is. 60 days for the whipped cream. Only 8.5 days for the honeymoon. Okay, Diego Domingo, time is against you.
Nedra, please.
Nedra Voles. What is the official... Hold on, guys. Hold on, we got a time factor here. Nedra.
What?
What is the official language of Uganda? Is it Ugandese or English?
Let's try English.
I agree.
Yes, English it is. You're right to try English. We've all tried English for a change on this show, and you get the square. Diego, Nancy, it's your pick.
Ken DeBlock.
Okay. Now, if you missed this one, the game belongs to Diego. Ken Kercheval from Dallas. Which came first, Roy Rogers or the first organized rodeo?
Oh, the rodeo.
What do you think?
I agree.
The rodeo it is. Yes, right to agree. You get the square and you do block. Yeehaw. Okay, Mr. Domingo, she has thwarted you there.
Deborah Sue DeBlock.
You missed this one. It's a humongous lead for Nancy. Deborah Sue Maffitt, Miss America. Before a male scorpion makes love to a female scorpion, they do something special. Do they dance or do they sting each other?
Well, you know, I'm a scorpion. You didn't want to know that. But I know that. I know this answer. They sting each other.
I'll agree.
They dance. You should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the square, wins another game, gets up to a real big lead. And the bell means the time is up. $825. It's sweet for the Scorpions, and it's sweet for you. You're our new champ, Nancy Shirley. Zip yourself right over there. Join Gene Rayburn and send me a shot at the big money. Crazy George likes it too. Get ready for a big one, Crazy, though, okay? Get ready for a big one because we're going to say goodbye to a man who's been here for 2 days and amassed in that time a total of $5,725. Hey. Hit it, Crazy. Congratulations, Diego Domingo. Well done. Okay, Gene, to you.
Thank you, John. All right, congratulations to our new champion here. We'll be back with her and our nine stars in a moment or so. First, this is for you.
Whatever you want,
bet it all that it's...
You can get Topic in stores, but this TV offer is only available by calling or going to gettopic.com.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Gene, what? Here we go. Well, 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 you're going to do it, aren't you?
I'm going to do it.
You're
going to
think positively?
Think positively.
All right. Thinking positively could give her $30,000. Let's begin. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. BB blank. $1,000 for the most popular. $500 for the second most popular. $250 for the third. Whom do you call on for a little assist here?
I'll start with John.
John, what do you say to this?
Gun.
BB gun.
Yeah.
Nathan.
I'll go with BB King.
BB King. Great blues singer.
Fanny.
Oh, good.
No, this is the hot seat on this one.
There it is.
Okay, you know, I really do have an answer.
You do have an answer?
I swear, it came to me strangely from the right, but it did.
It's not spelled right.
You know who Mr. Nixon's friend,
B.B. Rebozo.
It's so funny.
What do
he spells it B-E-B-E, but yeah, this is B, period B. Yeah. But it's all right, B.B. Rebozo is, see, the Gun, King, and Rebozo. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
No, I want one of those. I'll go with Gun.
B.B. Gun. All right. Is there a B.B. Gun up there? That is the question. Let us look at the $250 response. BBC, the British Broadcasting Company.
A bunch of Anglophiles, sure.
All right, let's see if we have a B.B. Gun under the $500 response. Yes, we do.
You're kidding me. BB King.
Now, if you had to second guess yourself, what would you say is on top?
King.
BB King.
That's a shocker.
All right, slide the big one. BB King is right.
Could have fooled me.
What did you think of it?
I did. Uh-huh.
And you rejected it.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, here she has $500. And that means you're going to play the head-to-head match now with any star of your choosing. And each star, remember, has a secret number in front, a 10, a 20, or a 30.
When you make your selection, that star will reveal that number and multiply your $500 by whatever that number is. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Go.
I'll choose Nathan.
All right, Nathan, grab the tab and give it a yank. $10,000, $5,000 is what you are playing for. $5,000. That ain't bad.
Hey, I'll take it.
Here it is. Blank school. S-C-H-O-O-L. Blank school. Nathan made up his mind very quickly, Nancy. It's up to you now to collect the $5,000 by matching him.
Hi.
Hi, aren't we all? Okay. Nathan, she says hi, we'll match you.
She
hi,
says,
Nathan.
Hi. Hi, Nancy.
Hi! $325. Oh, we'll be back with Nancy and our stars right after this.
Your favorite things are made for you.
You think it was fair?
It was fun.
Play for the love of the game.
Copperfit. Live limitless.
Okay, now we want to reveal which of the stars have the large number. Which one? Wait a minute! Wait a minute! All right, everybody get set, ready, go!
Well...
And the flag at it again. What's going on here? Robert!
I'm getting out of there.
Crazy George is getting paid off! Don't ever come back again! That's the end!
Say goodnight, George.
All right, stars, we'll see you tomorrow. But George, not you. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Babbitt saying so long for the Match Game. Hollywood Squares, Crazy George.
A member of our studio audience will receive Jules Jurgensen elegantly styled watches, ladies' sports analog with rectangular case, six diamonds and mesh bracelet, plus a gents' sports analog day-date in a carrot-clad case with matching bracelet furnished by Jules Jurgensen. This is Gene Wood speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson, television production.